Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Korky and welcome to episode 2, season 3 of Life After Lasso. As we mentioned in the previous episode, this is going to be the final season, so we should have about 9 or 10 episodes to finish this off. We're going to try and win some trophies with Richmond. Something I should have noted in the previous episode, which I forgot to do, was that whilst we finished in the Europa League spots for this new season, we finished in 5th in the league last year, so what actually transpired is that Man City won the Champions League, so we've actually been boosted into the Champions League competition as well. This is the season where the Champions League format changes, so it is going to do a 36 team league format now, so we do have some Champions League fixtures coming up. Before that, we'll get to the transfer deadline day news. We did make a couple of bids to try and bring in another central defender. We made what turned out to be a huge bid for Christian Romero, who put in a transfer request with Spurs. We actually decided not to go with him, and we have instead went for Kurt Zouma of West Ham. If you play Football Manager, you know how good Kurt Zouma is, especially in the air. As you can see there, he's got a jump and reach of 18, heading ability of 17. He is 29 years of age, so we are looking to get him now in his peak years. He is earning £115,000 a week as well, which is a little bit expensive, but I think it's certainly worth it. As you'll see there, the deal is 42 million, potentially up to 63 million. So he was the last player we brought in. We have spent 81 million this summer. We have brought in 96 million. Part of that was the sale of Tommy Winchester to PSG for 21.5, potentially 27.5 million. Tommy Winchester has played only 45 games across the first two seasons. He's only played one game so far this season, so it seemed silly to keep him when we're offering that kind of money. So we'll get a look then at the fixtures and some of the results for this month already. As we see, we've had a narrow 3-2 victory there against Wolves. We'll show you the goals here. It looked destined to go to a draw, and then 4 minutes in the stoppage time, Kukoc popped up with a winner. So shoot the goals here. First of all, Ruben Neves with a penalty straight down the middle, since people are on right. Dybala responds with a penalty in the first half. We're still in the first half, so in the third half, we're going to see it. I'm sure it does a very close. Little touch off the defender there, not enough to put the clearance in, and Dybala makes it 3-1. We pull it back in. Dybala involved again here. Play a ball in the roadhouse. He gets through in the 78th minute. And then in stoppage time, at the death, ball comes away to the Simons, put back to Bundercats, back to the Simon again, goes down the line, plays it in the post, and Kukoc is there to steal the win. So delighted with that result. We then followed that up with the Derby game, of course, against Crystal Palace. We've come away here with a 5-3 victory, as you'll see, and you may notice there, Kukoc scoring a hat-trick as well. So absolutely delighted with his form. That makes it 4 goals in 2 games. We'll show you the goals here now. Both teams playing in their record, of course. So a very easy tap in there. I think that Zaha gets the goal. It is, yep. Respond almost straight away with Zouma 6 minutes into his debut, scoring from the near post. As I said, we all know how good he is from corners. Lovely ball on the Kukoc here, plays across the goalkeeper, gets into the bottom corner. Keeper could have maybe done a little bit better, but we didn't care. A nice cross here from Goodman in towards the middle of the box. Kukoc is there. Kukoc wins a lot of headers for such a small guy. I think it was 3-2 at that stage. 3-1 maybe. You see Bundercats drills in for coming in the edge of the box to make it 4. Terry Pinchel gets down the line, puts the ball back to Zaha. It's his second, so it's 4-2 at this stage. Evander makes a lovely cross into the back post, and Teddy absolutely smashes it in. Left foot volley first time, and then Kukoc near the end makes a 5-3 for his hat trick. So absolutely thrilled with the performance there. None of the strikers scored in that game. It's a little bit disappointing, but we still played very well. We scored 5 goals. So, and technically speaking, we were away from home, I guess. We followed that up then with our first Champions League game. We are home to Galatasaray. Where injuries and suspensions are worthless, and still are. As you see, a very easy goal there for Yunus to come at the back post, pretty much unmarked from 2 yards out. Big ball over from the back, under the back post, and Yusu is there to make it 2-0. Lovely ball here from Hughes, plays into Junior Tart, nice control on the chest, it's a toss. And in the 79th minute, we didn't have enough to really get back into the game. As you can see there, Galatasaray, it was, you know, we've kind of dominated. We've played like the home team, really, which obviously we are in that game. So we should have done better. It was at this stage where a lot of injuries and suspensions have come into play, and we've kind of had to go with our more defensive 4-3-3. As you'll see here, Guido Rodriguez playing more of a part. Samuel Ricci coming in as well, featuring up more often. We've got a nice ball up here to Hughes. He gets the ball across the ball. He has a shot. The keeper saves it. It's falling back to Kukoc. That's it. 1-0. Samuel Bissanian, Kukoc companion, this time on the right hand side. Plays it back to Ricci, who from the edge of the area at the angle has scored in and made it 2-0 for his first goal of the season. Then the catch plays a nice ball here into the bar. It's a lovely first time control. And this is why we've got the ball as the score goes up and it's 2-3 forward. Callum McGrave coming in, making his first start for the club, plays a lovely 1-2 there. Next to one, over the shoulder, off the shoulder of the defence, scores his first goal for the club. So absolutely thrilled to see Callum McGrave scoring his first goal on his debut as well, no less. We followed that up with another North London team coming away again, scoring 4 goals. We did concede a goal in this one, but we don't really care. This is the Carabao Cup third round. So we've come away with a 4-1 victory. So Benacer opens the score, puts it down the line, Zorro doesn't move. Still flabbergasted at that. But a nice ball from Bundekets in the corner who's here. It is a save there by Turner, but it falls back into Hughes' path. And makes it 2-1. Nice ball up here to Dibala, who chips it in towards the back post. Lovely bit of control from Kukoc, back to Ricci and the laser box. And make it 3-1, I think it is at that stage. And Kukoc come back again. Kukoc involved again, plays a little ball back to Kukoc, who finds Zubisana, making it 1-3. That makes it 3-1. And so Bonacatz plays a ball into Dibala to make it 4-1 at that stage. It was during this game that Cao Henrique was sent off in the 80th minute for a second yellow card offence. So he is missing for the next game now against Liverpool. Liverpool currently sitting top of the league. They're actually second in the league there. There was a game on the Friday. I missed who that was. But as you see here, Danny Rojas injured as well. He's out for up to 2 months, 7 more weeks to go. Henrique injured. Jan Sommer is out for another 2 weeks. That's fine. We've got Tom O'Brien on the bench. Yamas is not fully fit, recommended 75 minutes. That's fine, but we'll keep him in there. Do you know what? Actually, we'll take Yamas out and we'll bring McDade in because we do need cover in that left back spot as well. We do need a defensive a striker cover, so we will bring Callum McDade back in. He's been incredible for us. He's been incredible for us. He played well in the one game he came off the bench in. Jamie Tart or Dybala, we're going to go with, Dybala's been such a key player for us, and Jamie Tart is Jamie Tart, he scores goals, he's got 5 goals in 6 games, so we're going to bring him in. Dybala can't really play in midfield, he can't play in midfield at all, so we're going to keep him on the bench just for now. We're going to bring Guido in here, we'll bring Dybala here, so that's fine. So we're playing against Liverpool. We are second in the league. We're going to just take a quick pause and we'll quickly resume. There was somebody at the front door, but that's fine. So we're taking on Liverpool. I think if they signed Josh Doig, they have not. I've misread. Okay, that's fine. Josh Doig, very good left back. I recommend the same. Robertson then hit with corner. Saved by Zorro for the beating his header. That's fine, we're gonna come back down a little bit. Then McAdoo brings the ball forward in the midfield. That's a box. Defense team Tart. As the quick reach goes back to McAdoo. Lovely ball forward to the side. Up the line, first time cross. Goes over and backs there to clear. First to Kukoc. Jamie Tart there, and it's 1-0. Get in, Jamie Tart. Let's see that again. Lovely ball to the center. First time cross. Just a nice side foot pass, really. Kukoc is there. And two defenders playing one side. Van Dijk, I'm not sure who that is. Beside him. Absolutely delighted. with a good early start against the wicket. It's well put out by Rodriguez, given away by Colin Hughes this time. It's come back in as soon as they're intercepted. And they're giving the ball away far too cheaply in midfield. That's a lovely ball for the Diaz. But so is there to pick it up. A little bit too sloppy with a pass. Given straight to Devon Lewis. Chips the ball in the other person. And he's quite unlucky not to keep that over the keeper. Sandro Tonali's in their team as well. He's about to take a free kick. And he's hit the crossbar clear by which he comes out as a tart, but there's nobody ahead of him to find. Let's change the mentality down to positive a little bit. Maybe a bit more reserved. Let's encourage the boys. Sammy Ritchie is now injured, potential foot injury. Hopefully he can carry on. Bombercat's not playing well, playing 6.4. Well, we're going to hang on to midfield, we're hanging on to half time. Hughes brings a lovely ball forward, the people just can't find him. Robertson cuts it out and it's a back up Alison Becker. It's a lovely ball forward. McAdoo had the interception. I mean, he got a touch on it and basically just gave it to Evan Nelson. Let's see that again. Technically, it's a lovely ball forward over the shoulder. McAdoo's there. I don't know what he's doing with that first touch. He's doing, he's trying to get subbed off, and he's going the right way about it. Good throw from Goodman, but to the top, there's no way around to pick up Peter's ball. An awesome ball, but it was a bit of a dramatic grasp of the ball there, going down on all fours. Maybe we should demand more from the boys. It's called out the cross, can't do it. Free header to back post. Salah. It was actually marked by Goodman, but Goodman didn't do anything. Unacceptable. It's very attacking. We'll change it up to a very attacking mentality. Make the tackle. Yes, good zoom up. Here's a ball. We'll see tackle in the second. It's a decent effort, I think, from Declan Rice there, maybe. We've got to change things up here because McAdoo's playing poorly. Bring Garcia in. Richie is struggling here and Bumble Catch is not playing well. I'll bring Sharon Duran. Colin Hughes is struggling out. And we will have a chance and it comes to nothing. Kukoc and Hughes both struggling for fitness. Guido is now not playing well. Colin Hughes to open the corner. Kurt Zuma's up and it's there! Kurt Zuma! This is why he's saying Kurt Zuma. This is why he spends 60 million on Kurt Zuma, is for headers at the front post. Let's see how it goes. Colin Hughes rips it in. Kurt Zuma gets up over Van Dijk. He didn't even hit it. And make it 2-1. That's what we want to see. We are going to look to bring Colin Hughes with him with an effort. That's a very good save from Becker. I keep calling him Becker because that's what his name shows us, but it's Alisson. Everyone knows him as Alisson. Callum McDade can play right wing. Dybala can play left wing. Matt Cook can play left wing. He's that little bit more experience. Callum is nervous. We'll bring in Matty Cook and Dybala for the wings because the two lads are absolutely knackered. 2-1, this is very pleasing. We're getting back on top. Liverpool are dominating. They've had more shots, but we've had more on target. RXT is better. We've had more blocked shots. We've had one clear-cut chance, which is one more than Liverpool have had. It's a big clearance from Zorro. Goes to nobody else in Becker. Looked like he handled it there, but obviously chest controlled. Ball goes right to Alexander Arnold, who's come on. Big cross under the back post, cleared by Garcia. Goes back to Trent. There's a touch from the defender, but luckily Zoro picks it up. Could have very easily been a nasty deflection in that, but thankfully not. Lovely ball from Hussein, it's cut out, close to Shane Dure, looking left at Gunnar's, a nice touch, can get a cross in. Puts back into his right foot, is that? He's making an effort to shoot. Oh my god, Obasanya from the edge of the box. Makes it 3-1, get in. This is our season. We're going to win a trophy this season. I say that now, we will win no trophies. Gunnar really making a run there, and it's maybe a bit of a hell of a touch. It comes into Obasanya's path. And it just does it. This is just a great strike. Coming away from Anfield with a 3-1 victory. That's a great result. Outstretched arms. Everybody thought we'd lose, and you proved them wrong. Everybody's delighted with that. So am I. Top of the league. You're having a laugh. We are top of the league only by a point over... there's somebody there in... Brighton have a game to play. They are 3 points behind. They do have a better goal difference. So if Brighton were to win their next game, they would go top of the league. Chelsea would need a big goal swing. Man City have beat Bournemouth 7-1 for the biggest result of the day. They have, of course, signed Kvaratskhelia. Not sure if I pronounced that correct. Who scored two. Haaland scored two. Foden scored two. And Bernardo Silva has scored. Why can't I get out of this? I seem to be stuck. But that is it for this episode. We are into episode 2. We're moving in now to episode 3. I don't need to see the highlights of that game. Yeah, so we can't get out of the highlights of that game. But that's fine. So that is it for episode 2. I do hope you've enjoyed it. We will be back in the next episode to play the games that we can't quite see at the minute. But we will be back tomorrow with another episode. Until then, thank you very much for watching. I do hope you've enjoyed it. As always, please like, share, subscribe, comment. You know the rest. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. We will see you in the next episode. Thank you and take care. Thanks for watching the video. I really hope you've enjoyed it. You can check out one of these recommended videos. And as always, please do like, share, subscribe and comment. It helps us to grow the channel. It helps us to bring you more content like this in the future. In the meantime, I've been Korky. It's been an absolute pleasure. We will see you in the next video. Thank you. Take care.